What is good, friends? We are back with World Cup. We got Toxin versus Bro Kappa. I think he's playing for UK and Bro Kappa should be playing for Italy. I assume this is going to be Specs, Azimuth, Gengar, Scarf Kellio, Spadef Steela, Morphis Dev Mew, Mega Morwall, and then depending on which one is the Z-move one, it's either Z-move Zygarde or Bandit Zygarde, I assume. And on Bro Kappa's team, Elisa with a Mew. So this Gengar's immediately pretty threatening to him. Like I said, I don't think it's gonna be a choice Gengar, because if the Gengar was choiced, this would be kinda tough spot for Toxin, because he would have to predict the potential T-Tar coming in. But since he's not choiced, which is what I assume, should be good to go. But he hard focus blast anyway, predicting Tita or Ferrothorn, and he misses, because, you know, it doesn't matter if you predict it's Pokemon. That play makes a lot of sense, because the Mew is definitely nice in this matchup for Kellio. It can also whisk the Morwile. It can potentially check the Zygarde if this Ferrothorn gets too low. So it makes a lot of sense that Bro Kappa wasn't staying in there. I agree with Focus Blasting, but he missed. And yet a Ferrothorn will either go for Haradots, or if he thinks it will stay, Toxin will stay in, he can also just attack. He goes for a knockoff, and we see it's Z-move Zygarde. So I think it's gonna be Dragon Dance then. So this makes me think that the Gengar was Specs, and if the Focus Blast hit, it would have done so much to Ferrothorn. And neither team has a land towards this. I mean, that's fine with me. You don't have to see land on every game. But yeah, I assume it's gonna be Zardwipe plus T-Tar, and not sure if it is Scarf Kelly, because he has Excadrill for potential speed control, and he has a few. Like, he has two bulky mons. This is also pretty bulky, T-Tar. Like, you can still see Bant-Tar and just rocks on Ferrothorn. Not really sure if he's defensive Tar. I think Bant-Tar makes more sense. And the Kellio Scarf then, like, same like on this team. Could also see Z-move Kellio, and which means he might not have a Scarf for then, because he has Sand Rush Excadrill, which is some sort of speed control at least, so maybe he doesn't have a Scarf, is what I'm trying to say. This could have Substitute on a Leech Seed, but Substitute with Z-move, I haven't seen that set that much. I just want to make sure that I'm recording my voice, because I'm not trying to restart this recording, so let me see. Yes, I am, okay. Because I've had that happen to me before, that I realized after 40 minutes of narrating that I didn't record my voice. So he goes out into Mew. They both go out into Mew, to be exact. I assume that's going to be a Will-O-Wisp Ice Beam then. Because if the Zygarde had a Substitute, the main reason to bring this in, you have Ice Beam. I mean, technically, like, Zygarde doesn't beat Ferrothorn that well. Power Whip still has a good chunk. I think Toxin just predicted Power Whip there, because I don't think he was Leech Seeding, because you never know if this has Substitute, like I said. So Toxin gets up the Rocks. I don't think his Mew will have Defog. I think he has just Rocks and no Hazard Control, because his team is not really weak to Hazards. I mean, Spikes will definitely be annoying, but like, I don't think he will be Rocks and Defog on the same Mew set. So Fire Blast does a fuckload, the next one will kill this. Not sure if that's modest damage actually, but that did so much. And on Bro Kappa's team, he might not even be Defog Mew, he might just have Rapid Spin or Excadrill, which would give Mew an extra move slot, like that could give Mew extra move slot, which means it could be Ice Beam, Knockoff, Roost, Will-O-Wisp. It could also have Volt Switch to bring the Char Y or the Tita in. I can see Volt Switch, yeah. But yeah, unless this was a roll, this next Fire Blast is gonna... Yeah, Solar Beam obviously does more, but not sure if he predicted the Kellio, but the Kellio is gone, and yeah, GG, that's what I think in the chat already. Italy is gold, yeah, Italy is number one at the moment, they're doing pretty well. Oh, yeah, one of their wins was to disconnect, but it's like they're still doing pretty well overall. So if it's Specs Gengar, I'm pretty sure it can't Oko Rizard. I assume Sludge Wave will do around 80 maybe. I mean, not sure why he went Keldeo, because Solabeam was pretty free there. Like, at first I thought, yeah, just Fire Blast again, but like, Solabeam was free unless you predicted him to go hard Gengar. But he didn't even really lose anything from that. But the Focus Blast Miss Elia obviously sucked and brought Toxin in the back, kinda. Like, it made him lose momentum, basically. I assume the Ferrothorn could have lived one Focus Blast, like barely, but definitely not two. But yeah, he's just gonna... I mean, if he predicts the Teacher Slash Fairy, he's gonna Focus Blast again. Because the Zardwai puts in so much work that I can see Brokkaper switching out. But on the other side, it's just a tough turn for Toxin because... like, Zard lives any one hit. Oh, did they change Shadow Bolt animation? It looked so cool. Shadow Ball didn't do much, so that was a mid-ground play, I think, because he wanted to... he didn't want to Focus Blast and have the Zard stay in, but he also didn't want to go for a Sludge Wave with the Ferrothorn in the back. I mean, there's also Tita in the back, which could have come in on Sludge Wave or Shadow Ball. But if it's offensive tile, like, I don't think he would switch that hard in. So Toxin pretty much just loses this game, I think. Like, DD Zygarde doesn't win yet because the Ferrothorn is still healthy because it dodged the Focus Blast. And the Keldeo is also Scarf. Like, I'm not sure, but it could be Scarf, like I said, and... even the drill would still outspeed the Zygarde and Sand. And the main thing that also... like, there's just a few things that make Zygarde not sweep at the moment. Like, Mew is still too healthy. Ferrothorn is still healthy. So, like, Mew could Wisp the Zygarde or Ice Beam and bring it in range from either the Sand Rush Drill to Revenge or the Ferrothorn. But yeah, he goes in the Mawile, he's probably just gonna Sucker Punch. And he doesn't even Sucker Punch, wow. So this game, it has been fun. Like, I know that he predicted the Roost, I get the play, but like, I would've Sucker Punched there. Like, I understand why he made the play. But like, Rocks were up. I know he could've Roosted, but like, I guess you can say it's a 50-50, but my gut just told me to Sucker Punch there. I removed this game. This game did not happen? Is that what you're saying? Yeah, that was fucking confident, exactly. He clicked it so fast, I think. The sun is still up, so he can still... even if he doesn't have HP Ice, he can still obviously kill... Zygarde with Fire Blast or Solar Beam. So I assume he's gonna... now we can see him roost here predicting the Protect. But yeah, a lot would have to go wrong now for Brokkaper to still lose this game. I assume this is just like a standard but Death Stealer with Leech Seed Protect. Heavy Slam Flamethrower. And... because like his team... like he has a Mew, but if he faces a Specs Lily... that kind of comes in on... either the Zygarde that hasn't Dragon Danced up, or it comes on the Keldeo, and it would kind of get a kill with Moonblast if... he didn't have to sell a Stealer. I mean, Specslayer is not really common. It's not only Specslayer that sells Stealer checks, it's just solid. It also checks some variants of Magina pretty well. It would help versus Greninja. Yeah, it helps with Ash Greninja to avoid letting that get the Ash form, because you don't want to switch Keldeo in all the time, because that gets worn down pretty kind of fast. This also helps with Protean Grand. Yeah, so there's a lot of... that crit did not matter, I don't think. Maybe it mattered if it got two low rolls. So like, they would have done 52, 50... I don't know, but there's a miss. Definitely deserved miss. definitely a Zerf miss after he missed the focus blast early with his Gengar, and he hit all the fire blasts so far and he got that crit too. Like I said, the crit don't think it mattered, but still. And this next fire blast still gonna kill. Oh, he also got a speed death drop with the Shadow Ball, but the Ice Beam still bounced the fuck off the Zard's chest, or however you say that. Like, that did nothing. That way, it's pretty solid speed death, and it's just the Ice Beam from a Mew that's probably defensive, so it doesn't do much damage. Roost makes it lose the Flying type, so Ice Beam is resisted, but he does freeze. So there's the Revenge Hex by Toxin, and he can Roost up here. I can even see him going for Will-O-Wisp predicting the Tyranitar, but I think he will Roost first. Because if he runs enough speed on his Mew for Tita, he can just Will-O-Wisp on the next turn. So, like, Roost is overall safe. The comeback starts now. Celesteela, how are we beating Celesteela? That is a really good question. I assume with Banta can damage it really heavily. Like, Stone Edge or Crunch? Like, Stone Edge would do a lot, obviously. Fire Punch would come in clutch if he has that on Bantar. I could see that because he has the Sun support, but it's not really that common. And if he's Defensive Tar, not Banta, like, I don't see how he weakens the Steeler. I guess he has Mew to annoy it with Will-O-Wisp. He does just Ice Beam again. And the Mews are either gonna Willow. I think they're just gonna Will-O-Wisp each other. Yeah, so Brokkaba wants to burn his Mew since his Mew is kind of annoying to him. And I don't know if he did the same or he just went for Roost, I assume, yeah. Because he wants this healthy. So, like I said earlier, check Keld. It also checks the drill, even though he has a Celesteela. Oh yeah, I don't know if I talked about Z-moves on Brokkaba's team. I could see Z-move Excadrill. So what's the play for Toxin here? Do they just spam Ice Beam? That's gonna be so boring. Like, so Will-O-Wisp in case Brokkaba wanted to switch. So he didn't go for Defog. Maybe because this Mew. Yeah, okay, so he shows Ice Beam Volt Switch Will-O-Wisp. So that makes me think that he has Roost. Well, did I actually predict the set correct? Because I think I talked about all those moves. Like I said that I could see Volt Switch to bring those in. If I recall correctly. But yeah, I mean, it's pretty. The moves are not that uncommon. It's just not common that you see Ice Beam plus Volt Switch on the same set. So it's gonna be only Spin Excadrill for Highlight Control. Because the last move has to be Roost on this. And what is he gonna go to here? Tita or. I don't know. I think he's going Tita if he's Bandit. Just click Crunch. I know that the Mew will probably be faster and burn the Tita, but what else is his play versus this Mew? Zard would die to rocks. I mean, I could see him sacking the Zard first, but nah, he wanna keep the Zard around that rapid spin with a drill. Okay, he goes on a Ferrothorn, so he's trying to knock off the leftovers from the Mew, I see. Yeah, that makes more sense. Going hard type maybe probably wasn't the play. Is he gonna go back on his Mew on the Will-O-Wisp now? I don't know, I'm pretty sure. He misses a Will-O-Wisp. I mean, there was Hex on both sides and he gets a knockoff crit. This game is weird as fuck. So it looked like Zava just won and then it got frozen. Even though we don't know how this game. Like, the Zardwish shouldn't have been frozen, but also this Ferrothorn would have been super low if he had the Focus Blast turn 1. Like, I assume how it would have played out if the Focus Blast with the Gengar hit. Toxin would have switched out on turn 2. predicting a Zard to come in on the Focus Blast or the Mew to come in. Probably a Zard, because the Zard is like kind of hard to switch in. I mean, he has the Zygarde, but it's not the big best switch in like we saw earlier. So is this Skeleton just gonna click Hydro Pump? Because Mew can only Will-O-Wisp this. Mew lost his leftover, so the burn is gonna be doing 6% every turn. And it's Taunt, so... Is it Taunt Calm Mind Z-Move, maybe? Or is it just Taunt 3 attacks with Z-Move? So it's not Scarf Kelly, so like its speed control is the Sandrush Drill. Yeah, it's Taunt Calm Mind. And I think it's Z-Focus Blast. I'm pretty sure it's Z-Focus Blast. He can't go for Protect because he's taunted. Just Scald. So maybe he doesn't have a Z-Move? That's weird. I thought he was Z-Focus Blast. Maybe Z-Focus Blast didn't kill from full. There's no point in protecting because your burns or leftovers don't even heal you. Yeah, that's a Z move and it's gonna get blown away by the all up pummeling. I mean, Zygarde dies to Scald, so is he gonna go for the extreme speed crit? Your type is Scald, right? It's not that bulky. Blunder playing, I think in an hour? Saying it's not Focus Blast, is this Secret Sword? I mean, I could see Secret Sword, but Focus Blast makes sense for me. That East did nothing. I don't think a crit would have killed. Yep. And the Mew is just gonna take a lot from the Scald and it's gonna get taunted. So, yeah, it was fun. I mean, it was hacks on both sides. But, oh lord, it turns out to be a 6-0 still. Holy shit, yeah, that Kelly said putting in some work, that Zardwai putting in work earlier. Probably will have to put Zardwai in his thumbnail because it still did a little bit more work. And, like, if it didn't get frozen, it probably would have. Like, it could have gotten more kills later on. And, yeah, Brokkaba wins for Team Italy. Thank you guys for watching, and we will be back later with more World Cup coverage and Dockridge signing out. Goodbye.